Say hello to my little friend! Well, welcome back to the Steve Robb Show. Okay, well, what do I got going on here today? There's something down here. We're going to take a look at it. And we're going to start doing some heavy-duty drilling. A lot of you guys know that I bought a rotary hammer drill before Christmas. Was it before Christmas? Yeah, it was before Christmas. Around Christmas. And I'm going to mount this tire changer. I'm going to show you this tire changer I got a long time ago. I modified it a bit, and we're going to get to that in a second. But first I want to show you a couple of things. Okay, you guys remember these things here? Now, the bolts here I measured, I'll take it out here. Yeah, guys, these bolts, they're not long enough. So I can put these inserts in, these ones here, into the concrete floor. And before I take you off the tripod, I'll show you how I centered this up using this. So we'll get that to you right in a second here, and let me get the camera situated. Okay, guys, here we are. I decided just to demonstrate this. A lot of people have never tried this before, but if I've got a big hole like this that I have to line up, I use one of these spade bits, and this is exactly a 5/8 hole, you know, and it centers it right in there. And as you can see, what I did was I put some wheels on it, and that's always a good thing. And plus, underneath, I welded this all together because this is all bolted, and it's pretty cheesy. The only thing I've done with this once already was just broken a bead on a tire, and that's all I could do because you got to mount this to the ground, and this is going to be able to take it off and put it back on. So I'll take this off and I'll show you what we got here left. There you go, guys. So here I got my three marks in here, nice and neat. And what I'll do is I'll get the rotary drill. And guys, I've had so many concrete, so-called concrete drills, and they suck. And because you end up just wallowing out a hole all the time, and this is the first time I'm ever trying this. So all I did was I plugged it in, I turned it on rotary hammer, and we're gonna see what it does, because I've never tried one before. This is the first time. So let me get out the drill here and let's start doing some drilling, see what happens. Okay, guys, what I got here is just a 1/4-inch drill bit. And so what I did was I put this here so that it doesn't go through the concrete. You know, just a little bit of a stop there. And all I'm gonna do is, this takes a 5/8 hole, but all I'm gonna do is just stand on this so it doesn't move and just punch in three little pilot holes first and see what it does. Guys, that is so quiet, you wouldn't believe it. Okay, so I can take this off now. Guys, that's going through there like butter. So I'm just going to drill one here for you, and we'll just see how she goes. See what I get you in the shot here. Let's just see. Guys, I can't believe I drilled that down that fast. Okay. I mean, guys, I would have been burning my bits out like you wouldn't believe with a regular concrete drill. This thing is just awesome. Okay, guys, I got a problem. I don't have a 5/8 bit, but I'm gonna finish drilling these out, and then my bit should come in a couple of days, because I did order it. And I forgot I didn't have it. Like, guys, I got a pile of bits here. Like, wow. Okay, yeah, so I'll continue this when I get my 5/8 bit. Now, I don't know whether I should have just used the 5/8 right off the bat or put a pilot hole in first. I'm not too sure what you're supposed to do, but I always like to put a pilot hole in. Maybe it doesn't make a difference, I don't know. But that thing's going in like butter. I'll get back to you when I get that 5/8 bit.
Hey guys, Keith here. You're watching the Steve Robb Show. You guys still here? You're supposed to be watching the Steve Robb Show.
Well, wasn't that just fantastic? Bobcat guy, right here. That's his old sticker. He's got a new sticker now. But that was pretty interesting. He's got some pretty high-tech stuff going on over in his channel there, and I just thought I'd just throw that in there now. And if you guys want to check out the Bobcat guy, I'm going to put a link down below in the description. Let's get going on to this drilling hole stuff, because it's been a week now. I got the 5/8 bit in. Let's get going. Okay, guys, I just thought I'd throw this in here in the beginning. Just see if you guys know anything about this. When I got the 5/8 bit there from Amazon with my transmission filter for my Chevy Silverado, it always comes with this little adapter thing here that goes for your filter. I've never changed this, and I've always been told that if it looks good, just leave it alone. Just thought I'd throw that in there. And by the way, up here in Canada, $35, you get free shipping on Amazon. And this is the 5/8 bit. Guys, this was $9.66. I went to Home Depot and it was $21 plus tax. I could not believe it. So this is the 5/8 bit here. And I'll just demonstrate how easy it is for this to snap in. And guys, all you do is you just put it in the end. That's it. It's like lock and load, and away you go. And I just thought I'd show you on the bottom here. This is the forward reverse switch. And right here, you've got a hammer drill. And then you've got another setting here for, this one here is just for a regular drill. I'll get a little close up there. That's just for the regular drill. And this one here is, if I can get in there. Yeah, that's just for chipping and that kind of stuff. So I did get some bits. And I'm planning on using this one. This is 4 3/16, I believe. I'm going to be using this one here in the summer. And this is a... some of them chipping bits and chisel bit. And here I got some, this is a 3/4 inch, 1/2 inch, and no, this is 1 inch, 1/2 inch, and 3/4. And then I got these assortments here. You know, I just put a little twist tie on there just to hold them nice and neat. And the plugs going into the floor. A lot of guys maybe don't know how these work. And it's just like a plug like this. You drill a 5/8 hole. And it's got this little doohickey in here that just fits. It just goes right in here. And then you get a punch and you hammer it down. I believe there is a specific tool for this. I'm pretty sure Gator's World told me that there was a specific tool for this that pounds it in and it stops at the end, but I'm just going with what I got. And I'm gonna use this punch right here to drive it in, and this hammer. So I think that's pretty well it, guys. I'll fire up the machine and we'll start doing some drilling. And guys, so far I am really impressed with this rotary hammer drill. You're going to see all kinds of reviews on YouTube, how they do different things. But you know what, guys? This concrete here is about 50 years old. So it's pretty hard concrete. So I'll get set up here and we'll drill these three holes out. And I'll show you what I got. Well, I can show you right now. So these are the bolts that come with these anchors. All I did was just make my own half-inch threaded drill rod, and I just welded a little bit on the top there, and that's going to go through the top of the frame for the tire changer and bolt into the ground. And I had Terry WTBM123 mentioned to me about putting anchors in the ground like this are just going to fill up with dirt. So I kept that in mind, and I made some plugs to go in here out of this drill rod. And all I did was just cut it off. I smoothed it out. I put a slot here so I could put a screwdriver in to just take them out so the holes don't all fill out. I'd like to thank Terry for that great tip. Okay, so let's get to it here and start doing some drilling, and let's see how good the 5/8 drill goes through this concrete. I hope it's as good as the quarter inch. Okay, let's go. Okay, guys, I know I got it pretty well zoomed in there for you, but I wanted to see if you could see exactly, you know, how good this is going in, because it's hard to show. But I've got my my little adapter on here, so it only goes in a certain depth, and we'll fire it in and we'll see how these things go. So here's the first one, guys. Guys, that was too much. Let's just fire the next one in here. Number three. Guys, that was just incredible. I bet you that's less than 30 seconds to fire them three holes in. With a regular concrete drill, man, I would still be there just wallering them holes out. Okay, so let me get my my plugs out. I'll vacuum these holes out and we'll get back. Guys, we'll just put the these little inserts in, just drop them in. There you go. Wow, they drop in there nice, guys. Beautiful. It's just below where I wanted, you know, so it's countersunk a bit. I'll just take these. That's all I'm doing, guys. Awesome. Okay, guys, let's get the tire changer. We'll mount it on there. Let's see if these holes match up. Okay, guys, everything just went sideways on me here. You're not gonna believe what happened. See these right here? Can't use them. This was the little insert that I made to go in there so that the makes like a plug so the dirt don't go inside there. Can't use it. Okay, guys, I had a whole bunch of these in there, and I picked one that was a half inch. And guess what? The three I put in the floor takes an M12 by 1.75. So I had to fire off to my friendly Home Depot. Pick up three bolts. Now, wasn't that sad or what? Now, what's the odds of me picking one of them anchors out that was half inch, and the other three, I don't even know where they came from. They're all metric. But, yeah, this is it right here. I never even noticed it. You know, the metric stamping on the end. So I'll show you what I got so far, and I got two bolts in. We'll just fire this one in here and we'll wrap this up. Okay, guys, I got the other two in there, and you can see she's pretty sturdy. I'll just fire this one in here and There we go, guys. That's it. She's done. And I hope you like it. She's pretty steady in there. You know, like, this thing ain't moving. And I can rostle it down now, you know, for putting a tire on there and everything else. And yeah, I finally got her done. Okay, guys. Thanks for tuning in. Come back again. Let's have some fun.